Good morning, children. Let's begin the today's class with a story. A story of two friends, Ram and Shyam. This is Ram. And this is Shyam. Now they are good friends. But in the past, they were not so friendly. Shyam always wanted to have everything more than Ram. Ram bought a dog. Then Shyam bought 3 dogs. And faced a lot of problems. Now Ram bought a nice watch. Then Shyam thought he will buy 3 watches. But 2 watches stopped working as he did not use them. Ram bought a book. Then Shyam bought 3 books. Shyam thought, "Why did I buy 3 copies of the same book? Foolish me." Ram bought a big pumpkin. Shyam bought 2 big pumpkins. One pumpkin got rotten before Shyam could eat it. If Ram ate 1 cake, Shyam would eat 2 cakes. Then Shyam would get stomach pain. Ram bought 1 shirt. Then Shyam bought 3 shirts. Then Shyam had no money left with him. Shyam was sad, but Ram came to help him. Shyam said, "Thanks for helping me. Now I know you are my friend." I shall buy only what I need. I need not compete with others. Since then, the two neighbors are good friends. Now, what's the answer? Who ate 1 cake? Ram. Who had 3 dogs? Shyam. Who had 1 pumpkin? Ram. Did you notice anything? Numbers. Today we are going to talk about the noun number and singular and plural. Noun and number. A noun can refer to one or more than one person, animal, place or thing. Singular noun. A noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. For example, a boy, a house, a flower, Now let's see plural noun. A noun that names more than one person, animal, place or thing is called a plural noun. For example, boys, cats, houses, flowers. Boys, cats, houses and flowers are the plural forms of the noun. Good morning, children. Welcome back to the online classes. Now, today we are going to study the noun number, lesson 6. Read the following sentences. A boy was throwing a stone at a bird. Some boys were throwing stones at birds. In the first sentence, the nouns boy, bird and stone stand only for one person, animal or thing. So these nouns are said to be in the singular number. In the second sentence, the nouns boys, birds and stones stand for more than one person, animal and things are called plural number. So these nouns are said to be in the plural number. Now see the following pictures. I have not pasted a picture, but it is given in your book. A book, books. A bat, bats. In singular, we will say a book, plural, books. Singular, a bat, and plural, bats. Here children written a book. It is talking about one book. And here what it has written? Books. It is talking about many books. Now a bat. Again he is talking about one bat. And bats. He is talking about many bats. Now children, countable nouns can be singular or plural. A book and bat is a countable noun. We can count. How to form plurals? Now children, let's see. Most nouns form their plurals by adding s in the end. This is singular. It means we can change the singular into plurals by adding s in the end. Now singular and plural. Bat will become bats. Balloon will become balloons. Bone will become bones. Cake will become cakes. Case will become cases.
face will become faces. Fingers will become fingers. Flower will become flowers. Horse will become horses. Lamp will become lamps. Chair will become chairs. Diamond will become diamonds. Door will become doors. Egg will become eggs. Egg will become eggs. Plate will become plates. Shoe will become shoes. So what did we learn, children? We learned that by adding s, singular will become plural. Now the next is umbrella will become umbrellas. Now see the next one. The next it has written here, nouns that end in ch, sh, s, ss or x form their plurals by adding es to their singular. In ch, sh, s, ss or x form their plurals by adding es to their singular. Now singular and plural. So children, what it has written in the first one? Beach. Nouns that end in ch add in the plural es. So beach, beaches. Bench, benches. Branch, branches. Church, churches. Now dish, dishes. Now see children, here sh has come. Okay, nouns with n with sh in the plural we add es. Dish, dishes. Brush, brushes. Atlas, atlases. Then nouns end with s in the plural we add es. Bus, buses. Class, classes. Now see children here, nouns end with double s, in the plural we add es. Dress, dresses. Glass, glasses. Box, boxes. Now children, the next rule is nouns that end in consonant y form their plurals by changing the y into ies. Singular and plural. Army. What is the consonant here? M and y. So when we change into the plural, what it will become? Ies, armies. We will add ies and it will become armies. Baby, babies. City, cities. Diary, diaries. Dictionary, dictionaries. Fairy, fairies. Lily, lilies. Party will become parties. Reply will become replies. Spy will become spies. Did you understand better, children? Now see, once again I am telling you, what is the consonant here? P. We will remove the Y while changing it to the plural. We will remove the Y and we will add what? I-E-S. So spy, spies. Story, stories. Trophy, trophies. Do you know, children, vowel? The vowels are A, E, I, O, U. the nouns that end in vowel plus y form their plurals by adding s to the singular. Now what it has written here? Singular and here plural. Now the first example, boy. What is a vowel here? O followed by y, and when we it will become the plural by adding s. So boy, boys. Now again the next vowel it has come here, e, monkey, it followed by y, and when we in this word again vowel has come e followed by y, so when we change into the plural it will become monkeys. Chimney, chimneys. Cowboy, cowboys. Day, days. Donkey, donkeys. Jersey, jerseys. Jerseys. Ray, rays. Story, stories. Toy, toys. Tray will become trays. Trolley will become trolleys. Now children, the next rule is nouns that end in F or FE form their plurals by changing F or FE into VS. Now singular and plural. Bookshelf. The last letter it has written with F. Okay, end with F. And when we change into plural, what will become? VES. So bookshelves. The next is calf. The last letter it has written with F. End with F. Okay. And when we change into the plural, VES, we will add here. And what will become? Calves. Half. Halves. Leaf, leaves. Sheaf, sheaves. Again F it has come. Shelf. And in plural we will add VES and it will become shelves. Thief, thieves. By adding VES, the plural will become thieves. Knife, knives. Life, lives. Midwife, midwives. Wife will become wives, wives. Wolf, wolves. Now again it has come with F and in plural we add VES. Scarves, scarf, scarves. Loaf, loaves. Let us see the next rule. Some nouns that end in F or FE form their plurals by adding only S in the end, singular or plural. Now, brief. Brief is a noun ending with F. Okay, and in the plural, what we add? S. So, brief will become briefs. Chief will become chiefs. Cliff will become cliffs. Draft will become drafts. Giraffe will become giraffes. Grief will become griefs. Ending with F, handkerchief. And plural we add S, handkerchiefs. Gulf, gulfs. Hoof, hooves. Proof, proofs. Same here children, ending with F. And in plural, by adding S, it will become proofs. Scarf. Now let us see the next rule. Some nouns that end in F form their plurals either by adding S or VES. Now children, here in the plural form when we change, we can add both VES also or S also. Now in singular, draft, and in plural, drafts or drafts. Ending with F, okay? Ending with F. And in plural, we add VES or S. Hoof, hoofs or hooves, both are correct. Scarf, while changing into plural, it will become scarves and scarves, both are correct. Waff, waffs and waffs, both are correct. Some nouns that end in O form the plurals by adding S to the singular. Okay, some nouns that end in O. So, bamboo is a noun ending with O, and in plural we are adding what? S. So, bamboo will become bamboos. Canto will become cantos. Ending with O, cuckoo, will adding with S, will become cuckoos. Dynamo will become dynamos. Hippo will become hippos. Ending with O, kangaroo, adding with S, by adding S, what it will become? Kangaroos. Kilo, kilos. Photo, photos. Piano, pianos. Ratio, ratios. Rhino, rhinos. Video, videos. Zero, zeros. Logo, logos. Now the next rule, children. Some nouns that end in O form their plurals by adding ES to the singular. Now in singular, ending with O, which word it has written, children? Buffalo. And we will add what? ES. And it will become what? Plural. When we add ES, it will become plural. So buffalo, buffaloes. Okay, in singular we will say one buffalo, and plurals, many buffaloes. Cargo, cargoes, ending with O, and when we change into plural, ending with ES. By adding ES, okay, it will come what? Eco, echoes. Flamingo, flamingos, ending with O, and by adding ES, it will become plural, heroes. Mango, ending with O in singular, and by adding ES in plural, it will become what? Mangoes. Mosquito, mosquitoes. Ghetto, ghettos. Potato, potatoes. Tomato, tomatoes. Tornado, tornadoes. Volcano, volcanoes. Did you understand, children? Read again and again. Okay, read the chapter. Then you will learn also. Moving to the next segment. Some nouns that end in O form their plurals either by adding S or ES to the singular. Now in singular, buffalo, okay, at the end, vowel, O it has come here, and when we change into the plural, we add was S, either S or es. So buffaloes or buffaloes, both are correct. Hello, hello, hellos, hellos. Mosquito, mosquitoes, mosquitoes. So children, either you add s or es, both are correct. So while changing to the plural, while changing to the plural form, you add s or es, both are correct. Let us see children, some nouns form their plurals by changing internal vowels. Here a is an internal vowel, okay, and when we it will become the plural, men, man, men, women, women, foot, feet, goose, geese, dormouse, dormice, mouse will become mice, louse will become lice. The next rule children, it is given, nouns form plurals by adding en to the singular. Now ox, oxes will not come here children. What will come? Oxen. So in plural, oxen, ox, oxen. Child, children. Child is singular and plural is children. Some nouns have the same form in the singular and plural. Now let us see. Yes, in singular and plural, same nouns are there. There should be no change. Aircraft, aircraft. Bison, bison. Car, car. Deer, deer. Fruit, fruit. In singular, fish. Plural also, fish. Reindeer, reindeer. Sheep, sheep. Children, some nouns have only plural forms. Name of equipment as binoculars is a plural. It will not come singular. Goggles is a plural. Pincers is a plural. Scissors is a plural. Now pliers, scissors, spectacles, sunglasses, tongs, all these words are plural. Now that second one, names of certain garments, breeches, drawers, jeans, pants, pajamas, shorts, all these words are plural. Tights is also a plural. Trousers. Now let us see children the next rule. We use a pair of before plural nouns to make them into singular nouns. What is a pair form? A pair of binoculars, binoculars. A pair of goggles, goggles. A pair of gloves, gloves. A pair of pants, pants. A pair of scissors, scissors. A pair of stockings, stockings. A pair of trousers, trousers. A pair of shoes, shoes. Now let us see the next rule children. We use pairs of with the number of quantity showing word when there is more than one pair. Two pairs of chopsticks, two pairs of shoes, six pairs of pliers and eight pairs of scissors. Children, read this lesson again and again. More you will read, the more you learn. Stay home and stay safe.